It's not easy to do what you did. You made my men look like a bunch of minimum wage mall cops.
All right, well, first of all, congratulations. I think we need to clear something up for the audience here. I feel like people don't know this, but I was actually your personal trainer for this film.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah, I just want to are you happy with the work? Because I mean, my big muscles and
I first said to you, you remember when I said I want to look like that? So
right.
I
helped you want to be a skinny fat guy like me?
No, I'm chiseled and huge. So thank you for helping.
No problem.
That's hurtful. Would you like to tell me where you received your training?
Well, first of all, congratulations on the film. I loved seeing you in this type of a movie. It was just an epic film.
I haven't seen it yet, sir.
You haven't seen the movie yet?
Well, I saw a rough cut of it 3 months ago.
Come with me and see it tonight. We'll go see it tonight together. It'll be a date. Anthony Hopkins and Kevin going on a date. The thing about this movie is your character banishes his son to Earth for betraying his ruling. If I were growing up in the Hopkins household, well, what's the discipline structure there? How would you have disciplined me?
I don't
me?
Have a family, so I don't banish anyone.
Right,
but I think I'm pretty tough.
Right, if I were to stay out too late, would you ground me for like a month? You wouldn't send me to another planet.
I'm pretty easygoing.
Right.
I'm tough on people who offend me.
Right, see?
Banish them.
Oh, I will never offend you.
Afghanistan? Chechnya? Who are you?
All right, so here's the deal. You know, you were a wrestler in high school. I was reading this. Is this true?
That's gonna follow me for the rest of my life.
Do you hate people bringing that up?
Actually, no, I secretly love it.
You secretly love it?
I do.
Okay, so basically, it's official that you could probably kick my ass.
It depends how angry you make me. You know, like the Hulk, it's like, don't make me angry.
You're gonna be mad at me for bringing it up now, so.
Yeah, just wait. When the camera's cut off, you might bleed.
I would actually be okay with you kicking my ass because you were so awesome in this movie. I'd be totally fine with it. I walk out of the jungle with like bruises.
This is from Sif, and so is this.
This is awesome.
I have sacrificed much to achieve peace. For through your arrogance and stupidity, you have opened these peaceful realms and innocent lives to the horror.
You know, in the movie, you're going through so many different emotions. Your character is all over the place, but you keep it really together. You did a fantastic job. But your character, you're trying to prove your worth to your father.
Absolutely, yes.
Can you equate that to in real life, where you tried to prove something to somebody, where you felt like you had to not go down an evil path, but you had to like force yourself to prove your worth?
I've had to work hard for a lot of things in my life, actually. I remember being told that I probably wouldn't get into Cambridge University because I wasn't smart enough. Mm. So I had to pull my socks up and prove to whoever it was who said I couldn't do it that I could do it, and then I did. Mm. I don't think I can quite relate to Loki's villainy in that respect.
Right,
you
never became a villain and just manually killed people.
No.
You can get into Cambridge.
Yeah.
I killed like 10 people so I can get into Cambridge. Yeah.
I'm gonna get a lot of letters from Cambridge professors now going, what did you do? Who did you kill to get here?
You are a vain, greedy, cruel boy. You are an old man and a fool!
You're unworthy!
Father.
I am! I now take from you your power! And I cast you out!
You know, one thing I noticed about this movie, I want to get technical with you for a second. I loved the use of canted angles. There were so many of them.
Yeah.
Like in these scenes, the camera's sideways. What was the reasoning for that? Like, what as a director, what were you trying to? Because I thought it was amazing. I thought it was brilliant. But I'm just wondering, what was going through your head?
Well, thank you. It's a strong taste. Not everybody goes for it. But for me, it was to do with the dynamism of framing in comic books, and it was to do with across the different worlds of the movie, finding a way of looking at the world that said the whole film had a kind of heightened reality, a relative reality, and that applied to New Mexico, which seems such a crazy long way from Asgard, but that they belong in the same film. But that also the world is. Because of the events of this film, the world is just slightly out of kilter. The world could turn upside down. And I wanted it to slightly unsettle, but I also wanted to say, this is also like the page of a comic book. As I see, I love the dynamism in the framing of the great comic books, and that was the inspiration for that approach.
Please, open your eyes.
Oh, no, this is Earth, isn't it?
Where did it come from?
I have to say this, you know, nervousness, you know, and there's so many people out there who are nerds when it comes to watching, like, the Marvel movies, like Thor and Iron Man. Were you more nervous about acting with Anthony Hopkins or pleasing the nerds? And making, because you did a good job with both. I'm just curious, what, in your head, were you nervous about making sure the nerds were like all like, you know,
with
the movie?
Equally sort of fearful of both, you know, for different reasons. There was more of the sort of the dedicated fans, so that could have been troublesome if they didn't like what they saw. Very passionate. But no, they were all really happy, you know, and Hopkins walking in, I was very nervous, met him, and he just puts you at ease, you know, he's just a wonderful guy, and there's no ego, and just loves the work, and we had a great amount of fun.
Your ancestors called it magic, and you call it science. I come from a place where they're one and the same.
There's a great scene in the movie where you guys, you're banishing your son away, and it's an argument between you and Chris Hemsworth. And as a young actor, he had to have felt intimidated, you know, acting against
Chris?
You. He had to have. And I was reading this, you know, this quote that Kenneth said. He walked up to you and said, "Let it affect you. Be upset. I dare you." Are you aware of the intimidation factor, and how do you calm down these younger actors that are working?
Nobody. Who would be intimidated?
No, like, what do you feel like these actors are like nervous to work with you? Since you're,
no, I always, we have a, always have a joke.
How do you? What's the joke?
Well, sometimes the young actor I was working with recently, and I could see he was nervous, you know, and I said, "Is that the way you're going to play it?" He said, "What?" I said, "No, it's the, no." I joke people. I make them laugh because there's no room for tension and fear. And I've been around a long time. If anyone's intimidated by me, well, I don't get it. You know, I'm a working actor. I'm a jobbing actor. That's all I am. And I come on, do my thing. I don't have expectations. And when I work with a fine director, fine actors like Chris Hemsworth, Tom Hiddleston, those are the two I principally worked with. And no sweat, no big deal. It's dead easy. I hope it belonged to the James Cagney School of Acting. No sweat, no big deal.
He has disobeyed his king. His fate is in his own hands now.
I literally saw a Diet Dr. Pepper the other day with you on it.
Did you drink it?
I did drink it. Actually, it was awesome. It was like, I usually
better than the regular.
I usually don't go do a diet, but I was like, you know what? I'm gonna try it out because she looks cool. So, have you had one with you on it yet?
I haven't yet, but I just saw it for the first time. I mean, I hadn't seen it in person, and this lovely lady that was in your chair before you got here showed it to me, and I was like, oh.
It's a little strange. It's got to be weird for you to see that.
Yeah. I think the Slurpee straw is the weirder thing.
Yes, you know
I was
what?
Like, people can drink out of my straw.
Yeah, that's what she said. No,
what?
No.
Yeah. What?
You know, to wrap me up, I do want to say this. A little Office reference. Your character has this interesting balance of badass and emotional.
Right.
And as an actor, though, you're a superhero in the film, but you're also trying to get this emotional connection with Natalie Portman's character. Where's that balance for you? Are you like, are there scenes where you're being emotional, where you're thinking to yourself, I don't know if Thor would do this. Am I being too emotional here? What's going through your head?
You know, I really left myself open to whatever Ken wanted to do. It was about sort of simplifying it all and just making it truthful. And, you know, the costume and the sets and what have you take care of the superhero element. You just have to make it real, you know. And for us, it was like, how do I make this personal? Father, son, okay, you know, I can imagine some intense thing that I've had with my dad and pull from that. Or brother to brother. And then romantic stuff, like, yeah, we certainly, we went in a very vulnerable direction sometimes, or very sort of different to what we'd done at the beginning. And, yeah, there were elements of yourself that say, hang on, is this too far?
Right.
But, you know, as people, we're unpredictable. And I think that's what's exciting. If you don't lock the character in a box and have one version, you just, you know, you surprise yourself and an audience.
Cool. Well, congratulations. Pleasure meeting
Thanks,
you.
Thanks, buddy.